Hello! Back again with another episode. I'll just turn this down a bit. Of Kane and Rin Streams, episode 24, I believe. Yeah, it's episode 24. Totally got this right. What was Russ count? No! We're playing The Mark of Kri, a game developed by the San Diego studios of Sony Computer Entertainment and published by Sony Computer Entertainment in 2002 on the PlayStation 2. That's right, this game is 17 years old, not 7, as some may think, because they think the early 2000s were only 10 years ago. They were not. They were almost 20, just to remind you of this fact. I know, feels a bit weird, but it's true. I contend that... time's going past too quickly. Anyway, I'm playing on my silver PlayStation 2, Slim. And this is an extraordinary, in my opinion, action-adventure game, which uses very unique control system. You have a remote view by far sight using the hawk familiar you have. Here we have The Mark of Kri. It is very much of its time. It is quite an old game, but it does hold up to this day, in my opinion. Now, I wanted to play another PlayStation 2 games. I do like playing PlayStation 2 games. The last one I did, I believe, was Maximo. I might be wrong, but I have to check my archives and reviews. And I went to the London... the London Gaming Market. That's it. Happens every quarter, I think. Or was it twice a year? I can't remember. Anyway, I went there for the summer one. And I saw that they had silver PlayStation 2 controllers. And I did buy a silver PlayStation 2 controller recently. I did have one for my Slim, but unfortunately died the cross button. Not X button, cross button. Because that's a square, that's a circle, and that's a triangle, so that's a cross. Get it right. The cross button wasn't working for some reason. And I don't know where it's gone, because I wanted to repair it, but I just don't know where it's gone. It might have thrown it, I don't know what I've done with it. It's gone away. So I had a regular black controller. That was fine, but it just didn't feel right, you know? So anyway, here we are, PlayStation Silver controller. So I'm giving it its debut run. I mean, it's a bit worn, I'm not going to lie. I think it's seen as fair. I mean, this is not its first rodeo, shall we say. It's a little bit, there's a little scratch there, but it, you know, it does the job. It's still silver, which is what matters. It matches the control, you know, consoles. That matters. Anyway, so let's dive into this. Enough of that. We've only got an hour, an action adventure game. So I've played the game previously. I don't think I've ever finished it, I'm embarrassed to admit, but no, it's a corker of a game. So I don't think I've streamed it before. Because just trying to remember, because I did used to do streams for other outlets and stuff, but doesn't matter. Let's just do a new game, right? So as you can see, I've got 4 hours in. But I'm going to use like an empty slot. There you go. Saving data to the. Have I got enough space? I've got two memory cards here, so saving data. There you go. Right. Let's just listen, shall we? Ooh, look. FMV.
He had become a fine swordsman, and his training was now almost complete. But why train if he was to stay in the safety of his home forever?
Why?
My master was restless. It was time to move on, time to take his first step into manhood. His muscles yearned for action. His heart sought adventure. His sword craved combat.
People who specialized in... They used to work for Disney or maybe contracted out to Disney. I can't remember. But it had a very definitive style. And it... So the sort of like these images between. And then they transition over to 2D. So here he is. This is our main protagonist, and I still regret not. So I'm going to bring my fan over. It's very hot, very, very hot. and I'm in trouble. So I'm going to put this in. Apologies for the fan noise, but it's really, really close. So anyway, let's walk around. I don't think there's any actions you can do at the moment. But yeah, there he is. So let's talk to these people. Let's go training. Let's do that. So you see the beautiful artwork between these. I'll just retake, if you don't figure this out by now, why am I playing this game, even though it's 17 years old? It really holds up. And it's only on a PlayStation 2, and I don't think it's on PlayStation 4. It might be on PlayStation Play now, or that streaming service they do, which I don't subscribe to. They might be on there, but anyway.
Good. Now let's beat on the dummies. The key to the craft is in learning to exact your strikes. To do this, you must use the right analog stick to direct your focus and select the target. Point the right analog stick in the direction of the dummy or dummies you want to select. You can also sweep the stick around. Use the right analog stick now.
Use it now! Use it now!
Your attention is now focused on the dummies. The dummy with the X above his head is your main target for now. You can maneuver around by using the left analog stick. Try moving in close to him, backing away, and stepping around.
So you get focused attacks, basically. Focused on single targets. He said the X button. It's not. It's the cross button. You got it wrong. It's the cross button. It's not the X. It's cross. I did. Cross button works. It's cross button. Not much left of that dummy.
Had that been a real enemy, he would surely be dead. You would then want to attack another dummy. Before attacking the dummy with a circle above his head, notice that he is far away. If the enemy is too far away to strike, you will see that his icon is transparent, meaning you will miss the enemy when you try to strike him. Try striking the enemy now by pressing the circle button. Before you try and strike the dummy with a square above his head, notice that his icon is also transparent, meaning he is too far away to strike. Move closer to the square target so that you can strike him. Try it now. The icon is now solid, and the target is now in attack range. Press the square button to attack the dummy. Try it now. Equally important is the ability to break your focus. To break focus, press the R3 button.
Doesn't explain what the R3 button is. I just happen to know it's down on the clicking on the stick.
Now let's try something a little tougher. When you focus on only two enemies, you can do more elaborate and powerful attacks on the enemy you are facing by using the open button to modify your attack. Focus on two dummies. Using the right analog stick. The dummies are assigned to the X and square buttons, leaving the circle button open as an attack modifier. To use an attack modifier, you must first press the button of the target you are facing, followed by the modifier.
Right.
Let's give it a try. Press the X button, followed by
this is clever. Clever stuff.
In this case, the circle button, to do a more elaborate and powerful combo attack.
Not let me do it.
Press the X button.
I did.
Modifier, in this case, the circle button, to do a more elaborate and powerful.
Maybe I'm not doing it fast enough. Let's have a go. I just did.
X button, followed by the modifier. In this case, the
Mm-hmm. I'm doing it. What do you want me to do? Maybe it's like both at the same time? Oh, yeah. You got to press them both at the same time. You gotta press all three at the same time! It's ludicrous! For this, you will need your bird. Oh, yeah. Guide Kuzo. When Kuzo takes a perch, you will be able to use his vision and prepare for what lies ahead. To find these perches, look for a beam of light that shines on a bird icon. Once found, center the bird icon in your view, and it will begin to spin. You may then press the L2 button to send off Kuzo. Try finding a perch and sending Kuzo now. There you go, send him off. This is where the astral plane stuff, we actually see through the eyes of the familiar. Well done. Or spirit animal, I should say. Okay. All good stuff.
Very well done. You've had a good look around, but you would now need to prepare for what you see. Press the triangle button to return to your vision. You can now maneuver freely while Kuzo remains on his perch. Be aware, though, Kuzo will return to your side when you get too far away. To see what trouble you are heading into, you may need to use his vision again. Press the triangle button again to use Kuzo's vision. Then press triangle one more time to regain control of yourself.
Try it now! Okay, that's Kuzo. It's looking around. Doesn't see where you can go, but anyway.
Now, you've learned much here today and should be rewarded for your efforts. But first, I must know that you've learned well. Apply these skills in your first mission. Then see the sage for your reward. To remind you of my challenge, press the start button at any time and choose
Bamusu's challenge. Try it now. Cool. I want to do this focus thing again, so... So...
Your bird Kuzo is an old bird, Rao. He has always been around, watching out for you and your family. He knows many things, including languages long since extinct. If he attempts to read symbols or words, listen to him. If he thinks it important to tell you, trust that it is something you should know. In the world that you can use to your advantage, Rao. They will always have the symbol of the triangle button above them. Standing next to them and pressing this button will allow you to use them.
Interesting.
Rao, watch out for enemies holding horns. They are guarding the area and will alert enemies to your presence.
I'm going to head back to the inn so I can go back to the inn, see if I can do first mission rather than messing around with the training area. Yeah, these pictures do remind me a lot of. So what's this?
You want work, huh? I don't know. Business has been slow lately, boy. People tell me bandits have made our neighboring forest their home. Anyone trying to get here is being robbed, or worse. It's made Balmusu nervous. He thinks it's the beginning of dark times. I think they just need a good kicking before they'll move on to someone else's forest. Balmusu tells me you've become pretty good with that sword of yours. Maybe you could... Well, maybe I've got some other work around here you could do. How about washing down some tables for me, or mopping the floor? Well, maybe you can help Tati clean dishes, or sweep up, or pick up after her. She's kind of a mess herself. People keep flushing foreign objects.
Yeah, and also about these cutscenes. They're a bit, you know. Let's clear out the local ruins. I think I'm going to do that. See how I do. I don't hold out much hope.
Cleaning the floor and washing dishes. This was not the kind of work my master was looking for. He was young and in search of adventure, freeing the land from murderous bandits. Now that was a job worthy of a warrior. He left that same day, his sword strapped to his back. Kuzo, his spirit guide, scouting the path ahead. The bandits had been terrorizing the local roads for months now. Rao had heard that they were camped out in some local ruins. He had also heard that they were many in number and skilled as swordsmen. Good.
Not sure about this narrator.
My master did not want this to be too easy.
I think he's a bit weird. Bit, you know, bit keen on the old violence. But anyway, let's just carry on. Like I said, I do love this, the art they've got here. It's fantastic. PlayStation Now, that's what it's called, isn't it? Yeah, that's the streaming service. So yeah, I think this might be on PlayStation Now. I don't know. But anyway, if it's not, it's relatively easy to pick up. It's not that hard to, it's not a rare game. So, save scroll. Save scrolls to save your progress. Press the start button and select use save scroll, which I will do, I think. Yeah, let's just save it here. So this is B rather than A. You've already got an A to save. Anyway, you can send Rao. How was it? Here he goes. So now I can go and check out who's, you know, around. Use the left analog stick to look around. Okay. Okay, so a couple of dudes over there. Chap over there. That's me. Alright, okay. Fly over there. Square just don't acknowledge the bird at all. Which is fine. Okay. I think I'll just leave it there though. Like a camera really. Oh, that chap's gonna, so I need to focus on the dude with the horn, because he's gonna alert everyone, which is not good. Keep on hitting the triangle. Cool. He's dead. As is he. I wonder if he can hit barrels. Oh no, he just gets stuck with them. Fua, Utsu, Mutu. Whoa! Okay, this is a bit grim. Okay. Oh, right button against strike, okay. Health bonus, nice. Okay. So I'm up above here now, this is what I was looking at earlier. I like the music too. I tell you, this game really, really does hold up. It's not. Yeah, okay. Looks like I need to head down there up the ladder. Clear this out, stuff out. But yeah. Okay, is the one with the. So, okay, right. Not sure if there's falling damage in this game. I believe there is. But, I'm happy that also this controller is getting a full workout, because it uses every button. This game uses every single button. So, it works, everyone. Hooray! And it is just direct and go. I don't have to do anything. It's a bit like Assassin's Creed in that regard. Ah! Cool. Kill 9 focused enemies. Love the animation of this thing. Awesome. And there's the offending horn. Okay. Right, there's another spinny thing, so I'll go send him over there. Oh, there's a scroll right on top of it as well. Handy. Try and get up there. Not sure how though. Right. So yeah, the left one button. Change, you know, sort of like, just look around. Good stuff. I can't see what's going on! But yeah. Rather not go down there though, because. Yeah, see how I can get there. Any ideas, everyone? Randomly sort of. Yeah, I don't think it's a, I think you got to get round the back, maybe. Oh, I know what I need to do. If I send him there, he picks up the scroll. Yay! Collect the save scroll. That's smart. And he gives it back to me. That's awesome. All right. I just saw it in the left there, the little spinny icon thing. There it is. Just popping over there. There he goes. What can he see? There's another one up there. There's one dude there across the bridge. That's me. I think he might be a bit of a tough guy. Memory serves correct, because I do vaguely remember. Fly across there. See what else I can see. There's another spinny thing over there. What's that? No, I can't see what it is. It's some spinny thing. But anyway, let's head across the bridge and beat this. Or try to beat. I'm going to use a save scroll. Yeah, I am. It's only one save, apparently. Thank you. Oh! Vicious! Oh, come on! I've forgotten how violent this game is! Wow. Okay. Cool. Okay, let's go. Good for gold. Up here. But there's a bit of button mashing going on my front. I'm not going to deny it. Oops. Ooh. Save found items, yes. Not sure what the thing is. Coup de grace. It is. Are we done? I'm not sure if we're done. I don't think we are. Let us continue. Bird's gonna reappear, hopefully. It's did. He's gone. You did. Let's pick up another save scroll. What's this game trying to tell me? Save often? Probably. Let's keep going. What's that? Nothing. I'm not saving it again though. Sending down there for reasons I can't quite fathom, but we can have a look round, I guess. Ah, that's why. There's a dude just at the corner there. And these the two as well. Okay. Use a save scroll again. Why not? Because I've got a feeling this fight is going to be difficult. Don't know. Gut tells me. No, it's a big health bonus. I shouldn't have done that save. What the hell? Yeah, run. Run. Totally run. You should really run right now. Okay. Send a bird down there. See what's what. Look through the bird's eyes. As opposed to bird's eye. Never mind. What was it do with the horn? That's annoying. Let's send a bird over to there. So he's going to call for reinforcements. Okay. Oh, closed in now. Keep going, I guess. Let's keep going. Oh, hang on. Bit of a standoff here. Yeah, he was a tough guy. That hurt. That really hurt. I wasn't blocking and it was a full health thing there. Cool. Just what I needed. So there's a big dude down there, there's a couple of health things there. But I need to get the full health first. Running down here. I'm gonna have to get down there and take him out, but I don't know. Okay, there's two of them. They're running against that wall. They're really getting excited. Thank you. These are real tough. Got him! That felt good. Felt really good. Anything else to find down here? No. Well, more of them's not. I'm saving too much. I'm a little bit worried about that, but anyway. So I could have avoided that fight, maybe, but I think I have to clear out the entire. Yeah, the entire camp. Anyway, let's keep going. It's a big old first level, isn't it? My first area. I was expecting, you know, relatively straightforward, teaching you the ropes. But no, it just keeps on going. Right, so we've got to do four of them. One of them has got a horn. Two of them over there. And that's me. Oh, what's that? Send the bird over here. Oh, if I sit him on there, he'll pull the trigger. Smarts. There you go. Yeah, I can confirm all the buttons work on this controller. I'm happy to say it did come with a, you know, a year guarantee, so, which is nice. And it's only £9. It's really good. So anyway, okay. I love the way they react to your brutal attacks. It's like, oh my god. No! He's dead, Chris. He's dead. He's dead. He's dead. Dead, Dave. Let's interact with this device. There we go. Oh, there we go. Wow, this looks serious. Brutal! I know I've said it many times already. Okay, let's get the full health, because I'm hurting. So I'm going to run. Got him! Need that health. Bad. What's going on here? I think I'm done. Woo! That felt good.
My master returned home
in
triumph. The neighboring forest had been cleared of bandits, and people were once more free to travel. The delighted innkeeper praised Rao's courage. He was a happy man. Soon business would return to normal. Weeks passed, and word of my master's skills as a swordsman spread far. Rao enjoyed his newfound fame. Though the stories were becoming a little exaggerated by his sister, who would recount them to anyone who would listen. Soon, Rao's mind began to drift once more in the hope of adventure. He would not have to wait long.
I like in a voiceover. I think he's the antagonist, though. I think from the tone of his voice, I don't think he approves of what the hero is doing. So, yeah, sure. So, I'm just going to do this. Ooh. Ah, that's his sister. Let's have a word with his sister, shall we?
Rao, can I come with you on your next trip? I know how to use a sword. And I can cook for you or carry your pack, please.
Silent. Silent protagonist. Best kind. What was this?
Good day to you, sir. I heard that you are the young man responsible for running off the thieves and bandits that plagued this area.
Indeed he was.
Good
bit intense, good but yeah.
Allow me to introduce myself. I am Aruku, a cleric and guardian of sacred land east of here. At least I was. Recently, bandits, similar to the ones you so gracefully dispatched, beat me and threw me out of my home. I watched as they broke apart graves and ancient tombs, scattering the contents. I thought they were thieves looking for gold, and once they found none, they would leave me in peace. When they found what they were looking for, not gold, just a scroll of old leather. They did not leave. Sir, I am the custodian of this place and have failed in my duty to protect it. Now all I want is my home back. Can you please help rid me of this menace? I have no money, no treasures to offer as payment. Just the knowledge that this is a just cause and the promise that the gods will favor any.
Did the eyebrow. Look, he's doing the eyebrow.
I also have a bow crafted by artisans many moons north of here that I will gladly give you upon your return. It is not worth a great deal, but does fire far and true.
Nice. I'm going to check something. Is there any options? There are. Camera control, gameplay, sound. This is sound. No, that's not the problem. Camera control, gameplay. Let's have a look at gameplay. Show. Vibration on subtitles. Let's put subtitles on. Oh, strange. Always show. Let's put the health on because I don't know how much health I've got. So, okay. Controller. Yeah. There's all the controls. Exciting stuff, eh? Yay! Sorry. I know. Never mind. Okay, so I'm not talking to him. He doesn't see. Oh, yeah.
Well, business is doing much better now. Thanks to you, lad. Oh, by the way, there.
Okay. Interesting. I think. Oh, what's up there? There's someone up there. Someone up there! There's someone upstairs. What is that? What is this? Who's this? Sage. This is the Sage. See him for playing levels, checking rewards, and for access to cheats. Ooh! Let's have a word, shall we? Yeah, go on. Let's have options. Look, he's out of drink. This is sad. His tankard is empty. No one's tankard should be empty. This is bad. Loading times are a bit off. Gotta say it. Okay. I like the dog. Oh, both of them. I didn't see that. He's stroking one, but the other one is just like that's just rewards. We've got movies and art, arenas, outfits. Movies and art. Hang on. Let's go back a bit. You can definitely tell the people who did this were master, you know, credits, the beginning. One goes chores. I don't know that one. Ruki's favour. Oh, there's another one. Interesting. So you can see old outfits. That's his standard outfit. There's many outfits. I do not have them. Makes me sad. Okay. Let's go back to the inn. I've only got 5 minutes left, so I think what I'll do is I'll pop down into the training area just to see how bows and arrows work, demonstrate that, because this does have a bow and arrow requirement, this particular mission, and memory serves you correct. Okay. Centering the camera's a bit of a pain. Can't hear anyone around here. All right, let's talk to this dude. Let's go training. It'd be good if they did update this, though. And it's a big ask, but if they did, the graphics would be fantastic.
Whenever possible, it is wise and satisfying to vanquish your enemy with stealth. This is to kill silently, with no harm done to yourself. To do this, you should be as quiet as possible, and so you must put away your weapon. Hold the R2 button and move the cursor to the hand icon to put away your weapon. With your weapons packed tightly, you can now sneak up on enemies and kill with stealth. This dummy is facing the other way and unaware of your presence.
It's a dummy!
By pointing the right analog stick in the direction of the dummy, and I will teach you to kill him with stealth. Use the left. stick to sneak up behind the enemy.
So it's teaching you about stealth, not bow and arrows. Sorry! Never mind. Cross! It's the cross button! You certainly killed that dummy.
Rao, if you fail your stealth, you will be forced to fight and have little time to make decisions. Keep in mind that you can tap the R2 button to quickly pull out the last weapon you had. Now that you have the basics, you can try and stealth kill two dummies. Move ahead to the two dummies standing side by side. Focus on these two dummies by pointing the right analog stick in the direction of the dummies. Notice how both buttons flash in a sequence. Press lightly on the left analog stick to sneak up behind the X target. When you are very close, you will notice that the icons glow fully. It is now time to perform the attack sequence. In this case, it is the X button, then circle square. Try it now. Before the first kill ends, and make sure you have pressed the correct button. I will let you try again, but real enemies would not be so forgiving. Let's try
again. Right, let's try again. Focus on these two. This is a bit complicated, bit fiddly. I like the idea though. Sadly, we're not going to see it in, you know, the actual game, because, well, full game, because we're stopping in, 3 minutes. Oh no. All good things must come to an end.
In this case, it is the X button, then circle square. Try it now.
Yep! I did it! So it's a nice combo action. Did this slice someone's head off?
Well done.
One more lesson.
We should be finished for now. If you have the opportunity to hide behind a wall.
This is great. What's this? I'm just going to leave you on this one. It's so good. When I first saw this, I was just so impressed. It's like so good. Anyway, I'm getting all excited. See? Metal Gear? Can you just do this? Swear to God. You just basically do that. You slam them against the wall and then kill them. It's so... it is so... Yeah, good, good. You're ready, Rao, but you must leave me for this warning.
But I must leave you with this warning. You cannot defend against an attack with your weapons put away. If you are ever caught in this situation, you need to be fast and cunning. Press the R1 button as the enemy strikes. And if you are quick, you may be able to disarm the wretch and gain time to draw a weapon. Keep that in mind.
That was really handy, I remember that.
See me before your next outing, and I'll see to it you are prepared with special skills for the job.
Cool. There you go. Well, I think what I'll do is... Yeah, we've got to call it there. It's a bit of a shame because I really wanted to show you, but this is the Mark of Kri. Fantastic game. Really, really, really good.
When you approach a scenario, it is always best to use
take stock of the situation. Yes, and yes.
Knowing what is ahead of you before you strike is an essential tool.
Thank you for the pro tips. Let's just do this. So, thanks for watching again. It's fantastic. Next week, we'll have my friend Pedro on the PC. Not on the Switch. I'm going to play it on the PC because it's easier, and also I'm running it on my PC, so there it is. I have it on the PC, not on the Switch. I don't know what I do have a Switch, I'm just not running it on the Switch. But anyway, it's available on the Switch as well as the PC. But yeah, My Friend Pedro, it's a similar sort of action-packed game as this, only using guns as opposed to a sword and bows and arrows and stealthy action moves. But if you can find this game, play it somehow. Don't know how you can do it, whether via on the PlayStation 2, if you still have one. I'm pointing one now. It's my just waving at it. It is there. I think on PlayStation now. I don't know. But whatever. Whatever is the case. Or if you've got a backwards compatible PS3. Who knows? Maybe. Then, do hunt this out. But it's a fantastic game. I really, really enjoyed it. And I hope you did too, watching me play it and also watching the game. I hope it inspired you to get it yourself. But in the meantime, thank you very much. We'll be back next week with My Friend Pedro. Until then, bye!